Lynnie Hinnigan, whether she's been held up in traffic, I don't know, but I've not had.
Probably the same way that I'm held to that for the council.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Declarations of interest, does anybody have any interest to declare in relation to the agenda items here? No? Item number two is the recruitment to the post of Chief Executive, and if you refer to pages 1 to 19 in the actual papers, which comprise of a report and supporting documents to seek agreement to begin the process to recruit a permanent Chief Executive. Can I invite, is it you, Jackie? Yeah. Who's going to introduce the report and comment, and then ask any other officers before going on to commissioners and elected members. So Jackie, if you want to present the report, please.
Thank you, Chair. And just to add on Theresa's apologies to the committee, she's had a family bereavement, so is heading back to Ireland as we speak, but was not happy not to be here for her first appointment.
You can pass on everybody's commiserations and be sure and condolences to all the family.
So just a brief summary of the paper. As set out in the report, we're asking for authority to be granted for the recruitment and appointment of the post of Chief Exec following the previous Chief Exec's resignation. As it sets out, we have taken the opportunity to revise the job specification so it better meets the needs of the city. And we're proposing that the post is advertised as a competitive salary. The determination of the salary will still be the decision for this appointment panel, but the advice we've been given is that will help attract the best candidates, and people in that position are generally used to negotiating, so won't act as a barrier. We are asking for approval to be granted the Director of People and Talent, and in consultation to the subject of agreement of commissioners, that we proceed to select and appoint a specialist recruitment consultant. The budget is available for this and also for the post, and we believe this type of recruitment is important to attract the best candidate for the role. A maximum budget of 50k has been set aside, which will be inclusive of all aspects of the recruitment. We've listed a number of specialist agencies that we'd be keen to approach. Very happy to expand and take any questions or comments.
Thank you. If we go first, officers, anybody who wants to answer that? No? From yourself, Mike, or Joanna?
Joanna has been leading on this work on behalf of commissioners. From my perspective, very supportive of the proposition and the paper and the appendices. Joe, I don't know whether you've had anything you want to add from the commission's perspective.
I mean, no, just to say that this is the most important post to be filled. We've identified sort of specialist agencies who know the market, they know local government very well, and I think will introduce the best candidates. The spec that they will be invited to tender against allows them to offer the best mechanism they think appropriate to find this person. So we're supportive of the process and absolutely recognise that we need to make progress now.
Thank you. Helen, did you indicate?
I had a few comments. I agree with everything that everybody said, and I do think this is it's a really positive move forward, and I agree with all the procedures that are laid out. I'd just like to mention, several things, but the first thing is the £50,000 budget. This isn't for the recruitment consultants. This isn't an appeal to change anything. I know those things are very expensive. But I just would like us all to be aware that's an awful lot of money for some people. I mean, it's twice your average person's annual salary, isn't it? And probably four times as much. Mindful of that, even though I'm not asking for anything to be changed. And then I had a couple of questions
just
about the job spec, if I might.
Yeah, it indicates a paragraph, Helen, and that would be useful there.
It's in paragraph 2.1d, 2.1d on page 2.
Sorry, that was in relation to your first point, you said.
Yes.
Sorry, if all you meant to first point.
Oh,
sorry.
In the job spec.
Yeah.
On page 10, at the top of page 10, I think there might just be a word missing here. The Acting Principal Advisor accordance with section 4, and I just thought, actually, that person's going to be the head of paid service, aren't they? There's a comma, but
yeah,
the
exactly.
Word
it's
a word. Word.
It's an
adjective,
yeah, sure. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. And then I just wondered about all the list of things on page 15 to 19. There are a huge number of experience points and skills and abilities points that are either essential or desirable. Should that maybe be refined so that
so
we clear about what's essential and what's desirable?
Yeah, so you go down to the second column where the asterisks, they are the essential.
Oh, right.
So there's a little bit of an explanation just above how we've done that, that the asterisks is a map of the criteria for the essential criteria.
Right, okay. Thank you. That makes sense then.
Yeah.
But I think we have had similar confusion
yeah.
in relation
yeah.
to other job descriptions because I think we are used to reading down to, so we might have a little
yeah.
just make a change
yeah.
in the right.
Yes, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Or potentially highlighting
yeah.
those are
oh,
more essential
yeah.
bones
yeah.
of exposure. Is that it, Helen?
That's it.
And can I just pick up on that? We are hugely mindful of the costs of this. I mean, what we do hope is by going through to a number of agencies, we can also find the best value.
Yes.
But we wish this cost less
yeah.
than it does. But I think that we all know what alternative career we could have if we had an alternative life and things.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah, we are very mindful of that.
Yeah, and I think that's the important thing is to get that
yeah, right.
best value as well as at the
yeah.
lowest cost. Because it's no point, you know, spending a smaller
mm-hmm.
amount of money and then if it doesn't result in something, so it needs to be considered and not wasting that money as well. Alan?
Yeah, I'd echo Helen's comments.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just a query about what sort of time scale is envisaged for £50,000. And just if this is amendable, I would like the word transparent put in on page 9, 1, 2, 3, 4 paragraphs down where it says fostering the culture of collective. I think it's really important given the context.
Sorry, which on page 9? Which paragraph?
Yeah, page 9, fourth paragraph down, I think a transparent culture because transparency and accountability is what's been lacking in this council. I think it's important to have that.
Yeah, we're happy with that,
Joanna.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't think anyone would disagree
with
that.
I think we're all on board with this, but
yeah.
it has to be said openly.
Of course. And just, we have had apologies from Councillor Ken. Members should have his comments in front of yourself. Have you seen a copy of his letter, Mike and Joanna? Just basically, he's affirming that he supports the recommendations and feels they're in the right sequence. And then there's a couple of other issues, really, where he's asking about other points that I don't think they're not relevant to this job, though, about the wider restructure, really, but in relation to what we're considering at the moment.
Chair, do you want
yeah.
just to answer better on the timetable?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the brief that's going to go out to the agency is going to be really clear that final appointments panel is going to be February. So then we will work backwards from that, and then all the other processes will fall into place.
Right, thanks for that.
We request on that is if there seems to be a delay that it's brought back. Could you report about sort of what that delay is and the implications of
yeah.
that on yeah, parts
of
the service? That would be really useful. No other comments from anybody? No, can I move then that the recommendations as set out in the report to be approved? Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Right. Item 3, we now move on to the exclusion of press and public. Yeah, so can I move that the press and public be excluded from the meeting for our next two items because the information to be discussed relates to the financial and business affairs of individuals as well as the council. Is that agreed?
Yeah.